Today we celebrate the Mass for the fourth Sunday in Advent. Our procession this morning, prepare for the wedding. Please rise.
God's commandments as Christ taught us by loving God and our neighbor. Do you clearly understand what you are undertaking? And are you ready to help these parents in the raising of their child in the Christian faith?
Yes.
Rabadani, the Christian faith welcomes you with great joy. In its name I claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of his cross. I trace the cross on your forehead and invite your parents and godparents to do the same. Brothers and sisters. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we too, in the incarnation of Christ your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Thus says the Lord, you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me, one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Therefore the Lord will give him up until the time which she who is to give birth has born, and the rest of his kindred shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm and shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God, and they shall remain, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be peace, the word of the Lord.
By this will,
we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joyful surprises. Mary is betrothed to Joseph and is a virgin, and yet she's been asked to bear God's son. And Elizabeth, who was barren in her old age, she too has a joyful surprise that she is going to have a child. And the description we see in the gospel, it really reflects that joy. The child leaps for joy within Elizabeth's womb because he senses that the unborn Messiah is near. And if we were reading the longer version of this, Mary breaks out into a canticle of praise. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. That's pure joy. And that's the joy that comes from our God of surprises. But as I was preparing for today, I found myself wondering if we always get that aspect of God. And certainly Mary or Elizabeth could not possibly have known in advance what was going to be asked of them. It came as a surprise. We never know what's coming, and God can surprise us also at any age. A couple of years ago, I did the wedding of a couple. She was in her 70s, he was in his 80s. It was so cool to see how love had unfolded at that particular stage in their lives. Neither could have imagined it a few years prior when they started to spend time together. And yet God surprised them, and at a rather advanced age, they experienced romantic love all over again. And I suspect here in this church there are a lot of stories about how God has surprised us with love, or new challenges, or new roles that we were to play. So a good question for us is, are we open to these surprises that God has in store for us? Are we willing to take the risk of saying yes to them? Or maybe we've grown a bit cynical, a bit skeptical. It's easy to slip into that mindset. We start to think, the way my life is right now, my daily routine, the way I feel, that's simply the way things are, and nothing's going to change. And that viewpoint can even extend to our relationship with God, that whatever our current understanding of God is, we don't expect it to change. God's not going to reveal anything else to us. We know it. And in fact, in some cases, people start to wonder, is God really as involved in our lives as we once believed? You know, these are normal things that people struggle with. We don't want to give in to that kind of cynicism because then we lose the ability to experience the miracles and the surprises. Advent is all about how God intervenes in our lives in ways we would never expect. And most of the time, it's not in a supernatural way. It happens sometimes, but most of the time, God finds his way into the ordinary events of our lives. And what he does is he surprises us with a new vision, a new way of looking at things. There is nothing more wonderful than a fresh perspective on life. I think that's probably why Christmas Carol is such a popular story. And because as we know, nothing external changed in Ebenezer Scrooge's life. The world was the same when he woke up Christmas morning as it had been the night before when he went to bed. But he woke up and he saw the whole world differently. He had a new vision, a new understanding. In his case, it was three ghosts and a former co-worker that helped him to understand what life is really about. For us, it's God himself who transforms our vision in life again and again throughout our lives, always giving us a fresh perspective and allowing us to see the world and the people in it in a new way. We just have to be willing to allow him to do that. When we do, we may be surprised at what we discover. We're now a very short time away from celebrating the Feast of Christmas once again. You know, we know this story by heart. We could probably recite today's gospel and the nativity stories by heart. You know, but one thing that I think God invites us to do is to allow ourselves to be surprised once again. Every year, we experience these stories a little bit differently. We're not the same people we were a year ago. A lot's happened. If we reflect on the past year, each one of us, what was my life like a year ago, and what has happened, we'll understand that we've changed, and because we've changed, we're going to experience the birth of Christ differently. And so let us allow ourselves to be surprised by God and to give our vision over to a new way of seeing things, and that is a perspective that only God can give. And of course, in today's gospel, we have two women who are about to bear children, and they're filled with joy. We have the great joy today of having a baptism. So would you please come forward and stand here? My dear brothers and sisters, let us ask our Lord Jesus Christ to look lovingly upon this child who is to be baptized, on his parents and godparents, and upon all the baptized. And by the mystery of your death and resurrection, bathe this child in light, give him the new life of baptism, and welcome him into your holy church. We pray to the Lord. Through baptism and confirmation, make him your faithful follower and a witness of your gospel. Pray to the Lord. Lead him by a holy life to the joys of God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord. And make the lives of his parents and his godparents examples of faith to inspire this child. We pray to the Lord. And keep his family always in your love. We pray to the Lord. And renew the grace of our baptism in each one of us. Pray to the Lord. And Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, spirit of evil, and to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness and bring him into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray for this child. Set him free from original sin. Make him a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell within him. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, we now ask God to give this child new life in abundance through water and the Spirit. So we pray. Father, you give us grace through sacramental signs, which tell us of the wonders of your unseen power. In baptism, we use your gift of water, which you have made a rich symbol of the grace you give us in this sacrament. At the very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathed on the waters, making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end of sin and a new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Spirit. Your son willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung from the cross. After his resurrection, he told his disciples, "Go out and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Father, look now with love upon your church and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. By the power of your grace, give to the water at this font the grace of your Son. You created us in your own likeness. Cleanse us from sin with a new birth to innocence by water and the Spirit. So we ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism rise also with him to newness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord."
Amen.
And dear parents and godparents and our entire assembly, you have come here to present this child for baptism. By water and the Holy Spirit, he is to receive the gift of the new life from God, who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring him up in the faith. See that the divine life which God gives him is kept safe from the poison of sin to grow always stronger in his heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew them now the vows of your own baptism. Reject sin. Profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church, and this is the faith in which this child is about to be baptized. And so we will all profess this faith with you once again. So I ask you, do you reject Satan?
Amen.
And all his works?
Amen.
And all his empty promises?
Amen.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
Amen.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
Amen.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
And this is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
And so is it your will that Ramadani should be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we have all professed with you? So Ramadani, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin, given you new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and welcomed you into his holy temple. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you always live as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. This represents the Holy Spirit. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. The This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. He is to walk always as a child of the light. May he keep the flame of faith alive in his heart. And when the Lord comes, may he go to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. And you have put on Christ, in him you have been baptized. Alleluia, alleluia. And congratulations.
For the church, that these final days of Advent may allow time for prayer and reflection on the coming feast of the Nativity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our nation may respect the diversity of Christian and non-Christian religious holidays during the season and focus on the positive values that draw us together, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those for whom the holidays are painful, due to personal loss or loneliness, that they may receive the love and support they need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and for all those who continue to be affected by the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who have died, especially Verdell Moody and David Alexander, who passed away this week, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pause now to call mind to our intentions of our heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Holy God, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon us and prepare our hearts for the coming of your Son, and may I share the joyful news of the gospel with all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang at his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice in the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we are acclaimed. Mystery of faith. Your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, who may bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you. Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. Just a couple of announcements. First of all, Christmas Eve Mass, 9 p.m. Christmas Day Mass will be at 9 a.m., so fairly easy to remember. And speaking of Christmas, our Environment Committee could use some help after Mass today, bringing out and setting up some of the decorations for the church. Some of them, you know, require some heavy lifting. So if you have a chance, your help would be greatly appreciated. The parish offices will be closed Christmas Eve, and then Monday and Friday will follow. Ladies Guild will be passing out bags of candy downstairs after Mass today. Do we have any visitors today? Anybody back? Welcome. It's good to have you with us. We haven't been back for the first time since COVID. Okay, well, we have a blessing for the mom and dad. So if you could please stand, give us a feed in Daniel. Special blessing to the parents, and so we start with Josephina. God the Father, through his Son, the Virgin Mary's child, has brought joy to all Christian mothers as they see the hope of eternal life shine on their children. May he bless the mother of this child. She now thanks God for the gift of her child. May she be one with him in thanking him forever in heaven, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
God is the giver of life, human and divine. May he bless the father of this child. He and his wife will be the first teachers of their child in the ways of faith. May they also be the best of teachers, bearing witness to the faith by what they say and do, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
For all gathered here, by God's gift through water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn to everlasting life. In his goodness, may he continue to pour out his blessings upon these sons and daughters of his. May he make them always, wherever they may be, faithful members of his holy people. May he send his peace upon all who are gathered here, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Mighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional is blessed.